Bridges, as most people interested in anything paranormal would be aware of, have been directly linked with paranormal phenomena for years. In fact, for centuries. From the Mothman to the Man-Monkey, bridges have a way of attracting certain paranormal phenomena that most just simply can't explain. The old Alton Bridge in Texas is one of them. Built in 1884 by the King Iron Manufacturing Bridge Company, its original purpose was to carry horses and automobiles across the river. Though it is called the Old Alton Bridge, the community of Alton had already dispersed by 1884. Denton County itself was formed in 1846, and the first attempt at settling the county seat was Pinckneyville, named for the Texas governor. However, water shortages forced politicians to move 2 years later in 1848. The new town site was located on a high ridge between Pecan Creek and Hickory Creek and was called Alton. Their luck with the second town site didn't last very long. In 1850, they moved once more to a location 5 miles from present-day Corinth. This attempt was more successful. The Hickory Creek Baptist Church was organized in 1855, and by 1856, there were several buildings, including a school and a saloon. However, the county seat was moved again in 1857 to Denton. The post office closed forever in 1859. Today, the Baptist Church and the Alton Cemetery are all that remains of the Alton Village. Years later, in 1884, long after Alton had died, an iron through truss bridge was built over Hickory Creek on Copper Canyon Road south of the old town site. Built by the King Bridge Company of Cleveland, Ohio, this 145-foot-long bridge would serve area travelers for more than a century. Called the Old Alton Bridge, sometimes the Argyle Bridge, it was first built to carry horses, but would later carry vehicles across the creek. It continued to be used until about 2001, when it was replaced by a concrete and steel bridge and a new road, which straightened out of a sharp curve. Before the new bridge was built, motorists were required to honk their horns on the one-lane bridge to let other travelers know they were coming. It didn't earn the title of Goatman until half a century later, when an African-American named Oscar Washburn settled in the area. He earned a living by raising and selling goats. He was successful, and most of the community was supportive and friendly towards Washburn and his family, but unfortunately, the local KKK was not so pleased. Washburn posted a sign on the bridge which read, "This way to the Goatmans." This action angered members of the Klan, and a fateful night in August of 1938, they drove their cars across the bridge with their headlights off, took Washburn from his home and family, and dragged him to the bridge. The legend goes that they then fitted a noose over his head and threw him over the side of the bridge, but when they looked to see whether he was dead, his body had disappeared. They returned to his home and slaughtered his family, according to the legend. Washburn was never seen or heard from again. Some say, though, that the body hung for several days, and many townsfolk would come and take pictures, until the body then disappeared. Or that one kind-hearted local decided to take the body down by cutting the rope to give the body a proper burial. Rumors that the Goatman still roamed the area began soon after. People reported seeing him walking across the bridge or standing near the grounds where his shanty stood. The stories grew and several members of the lynch mob died under mysterious circumstances. One died choking as he ate his dinner, and one took ill and died of fever, hallucinating and shouting at ghosts. Two were killed in a drunken car accident while crossing the Alton Bridge at night. Though any trace of Oscar Washburn, his family, and his home having long since disappeared, residents will tell you this ghost still lingers in the area. Car wrecks on the nearby road are attributed to the wrath of the Goatman. Visitors report seeing his ghost walking along the river, while others claim to have seen his body hanging from the bridge. Others still say that if you visit the bridge at midnight, the ghost of the Goatman will attack you, and that if you stand where his home once stood, you will feel your skin begin to burn. A similar tale to Washburn's predates the building of the bridge, in which a group of cowboys lynched a goat herder called Jack Kendall. Supposedly, this was near the location of the bridge. The legend goes that Kendall's body reanimated through the power of voodoo, ripped off the head of a nearby goat and replaced his head with the goat's as the astonished cowboys watched in terror. Whether it's Washburn or Kendall haunting the bridge, lots of strange things have happened around the Alton Bridge itself. Travelers say that if you cross the bridge without your headlights, the Goatman will meet you on the other side. There have been reports of abandoned cars with no sign of their occupants, vehicles breaking down or car doors locking and unlocking of their own accord, and some people have heard hoofbeats around the bridge. According to legend, if you visit on Halloween and honk your car horn twice, visitors can see Goatman's glowing eyes. One of the more disturbing variations of a bridge experience tells of a man waiting on the other side of the bridge with a goat head under each arm. Some people have seen a half-man, half-goat figure, similar to a satyr. This odd account of after-death transformation, if it is indeed the Goatman, bears some semblance to the tale of the Donkey Lady Bridge, or La Llorona. Some folks believe that Satanists have performed dark rituals on the bridge and opened a portal to another dimension. There have also been reports of inhuman screams coming from the nearby woods, or maniacal laughter sounding in the night. Though there are no records that Washburn or Kendall ever existed, to this day, there still are some odd occurrences happening around the old Alton Bridge. It's a question of whether you yourself want to go there one day. Just do your friends a little bit of a favor. Don't knock on the bridge, or drive over it with your headlights off, or else you might not come back and be stuck in the woods on that bridge with the Goatman for eternity. If you like what you heard, don't forget to leave a like and leave a comment in the comment sections down below. Would you actually go to the bridge at night? Would you knock on it, drive over it with no headlights? And don't forget to check in on Monday for another of the Unknown Files here on Unknown Territory.